Podcasting doesn't play the algorithm game, right? So a lot of businesses have started things on Instagram and Facebook. And if we know anything about that, right, you're fighting the algorithm. So you're lucky if 1 to 5% of your audience actually sees your post. And then you play an even uglier game by saying things like, check out the link or follow us on our website. Or like, there's all these little tag words that if you were to put on Instagram or Facebook, they basically are like, no, you're not going to sell on here. You're not selling. So we're going to make sure no one sees this. Whereas I feel like with podcasting, they don't play that game. There's no algorithm. So you're not fighting against like, how do I carefully articulate this in a way that sounds like I'm not selling? You can, it is like having your own radio show. It's like having the Mountain West radio show. I'm going to give you everything you need to know. And as a business owner, this is my favorite part. You have unlimited content. Think about every sales call you've ever gotten on when you went to sell your product or service and the 21 questions that you get asked as rejections or questions or uncertainty or confusion. This is your content. You could literally title every episode with every question that you've ever been asked. Like what are the top three questions that you get asked before people buy into services with Mountain West?
So for me is, can you really do this? Is this legal?
Is it real?
That's number one. Number two is, where do I find assets? Like, where do I find something to purchase? And then number three, what if I don't have enough money in my account? How can I purchase assets?
Mm. So an episode on, do you really have enough money to purchase assets? Answering that for 25 minutes. Like, here's some examples. Here's some things that we thought of, you know? The other one, what did you say? Can you really do this? What do you guys call yourselves? I know it's Mountain West, but what is
self-directed IRA administrator?
Okay, so self-directed IRA. Can you really do this? What crazy things can you do through a self-directed IRA? Like, surprise, what are some things you can do through a self-directed IRA?
Man.
If you're just doing this through a self-directed IRA, you're losing money.
You see Megan on the side. Says, I second that about a podcast. She's been trying to get me to do a podcast for a while now.
See? I was looking at the private chat, so I had to click the button, but now I see it, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So it's there. And then the thing is like, so here's the worst case scenario with starting a podcast, right? Everybody wants to see two sides. Worst case scenario, we've had clients that stay remotely small. So they only serve 200 to 300, 400, 500 listeners a month. But you have to go back to the intimacy. Every time I check in with them, they're like, I know, and I wish I was bigger, and I wish I could scale this, but like, I have at least 30 people a month that rely on this content. Like, I have 50 people that will buy everything I put out in the market. You know, I have, and then here's the other one for business owners. Please listen to this part. This is the most inexpensive way to network you will ever network in your life. Like, there is a podcast out there with a guy, and I can't think of his name, but he literally, all he does is interview other people about creative investment portfolios. Mm-hmm. So they just get on the podcast and he's like, okay, tell me about your portfolio. And they tell him all the things. And he's like, okay, well, how did you 10X that? How did you 3X that? Why did you do that? And they literally just go through everything in their investment portfolio. And then at the end, they talk the person into like investing in something with them live on the podcast.
What?
Yes. And so it's like, this is the most unique way to network. Even if, let's say for existence, I don't know who exactly your ideal client is, but let's say you had somebody in mind that was a business owner that had a service. Why couldn't you invite them and say like, hey, come join me on the Mountain West podcast. Or maybe you give it a name that's more related to the work that you do. Come join me on the podcast. Would you be willing to talk about your business, which is free promo for them, X, Y, and Z. And then this leads you to building a relationship and a conversation around them becoming a potential client.
Love that. Love that method. Okay. So podcasting, I forgot what the question was. You mentioned before, time commitment. I wanted to know the time commitment for somebody who wants to launch a podcast.
So that's why we do what we do, is to make it seamless, because it can be time consuming. And there's like a little bit of a technical curve to it, I would say. It's something that you have to learn and you have to learn deeply. But once you learn it, it's the same thing over and over again. Mm-hmm. So in order for you to publish a decent podcast, there's two major requirements, right? You want quality audio and you want consistency. One of the things that we absolutely, it's cute, but we won't deal with it, is when people say like, oh, well, what if I just want to do one or two podcasts a month? that won't fly. It won't work for anyone. You can almost sign up on the dotted line that you will not be successful. So you have to have at least 4 episodes a month consistently where people can rely on your content. You have to pick a day of frequency. So I say, like, if you're going to come out on Mondays, you better have an episode every Monday. If you're going to come out on Thursdays, every Thursday. You will build a loyal audience, but if they go there 1 week and you're not there, you better believe they're going to move on to the next. So they want to be able to rely on you and be dependent on your content to get them to where they're trying to go, to their desired transformation, right? Mm-hmm. So one, you want that consistency. In order to edit, mix, master, and write some show notes and record content, an hour for recorded content, editing maybe 2 hours, you're probably looking at 5 to 6 hours a week. Posting, writing the content, maybe creating some marketable piece or audiogram. Mm-hmm. Maybe 5 to 6 hours a week. So maybe 25 to 30 hours a month for you to run a well-produced podcast. And then, of course, you want the quality audio. So you want to be able to be good at editing so that you have the quality audio. And you want to make sure that you have the right studio set up, because there's a lot of inexpensive mics out there. And there is an inexpensive way to set up a podcast studio. Absolutely inexpensive. However, there are some mics out there that will get you, that you'll get a mic and it won't provide the same audio quality. So again, consistency and audio quality, and that's going to require you to know how to edit, mix, master, and do some of the technical things. And there's a niche for everything. This is like, there's so much. Like, anyone that thinks that their content wouldn't be podcast worthy is fooled, because I have seen it all.
Give some examples of some podcast worthy content.
Say what?
Give some examples of podcast worthy content.
Anything and everything. So I've had podcast clients that talk to animals. So their entire podcast is they interview animals, literally talk to the animal owner and tell them what the animal's thinking. There is meditation podcasts that will literally play the music the whole time and they talk in a very low tone for you to meditate throughout the podcast. And then we have a podcast that an esthetician studio, mm-hmm. and they literally talk about skincare for men and women. It's hilarious, I think. She always talks about how men don't wash their face. she brings in leads from that podcast, and she always provides a discount to anyone that comes in and says that they've listened to the podcast. We have some really interesting stuff. I've seen it all. There's comedic podcasts. Those do really well. There's documentary podcasts. A lot of them are like crime. So crime is one of the most popular podcast industries or niches out there, where they tell this ongoing story about what has happened. I call them banter podcasts, which are like, those are some of the most popular, where a group of 2, 3, 4 people get together and they talk about any and everything from politics to current events to related things. And they argue and have unique conversations around them. So there's no limit on what content you can produce.
Just makes somebody feel like they're just right there enjoying the conversation, a part of it.
That's the point. You want people to feel like they're in the living room with you, like they're in there having a conversation with you. You want them to feel like you are reachable. And this is what I really want people to understand. I'm going to say 2 things. I really think we're going into an era of, like, I think we saw this wave, right? We saw this wave in like 10, 20 years ago of everybody was like, they wanted to put the business front facing, the brand, the logo front facing, and then all the workers to get behind them. And you wanted the mission and the vision and the work to be critical and upfront. And I think now we're kind of switching into this place of like, people want to buy from brands and people that they feel relatable to, that they feel like they can be loyal to. They want to buy services and products from a brand with a soul. So how do you create that intimacy from a major business standpoint? You have to build some type of intimacy. And the best way to do that is through a podcast. Why? Do you know how much more likely somebody would be to buy from you if they knew the CEO or the founder or the market operations director really truly cared about the product that they designed or created, mm-hmm. all centered around the potential client, and the client's listening and like, wow, look at the effort this person put into this product or service design. This is really designed to help me. I love her theory. I love why she's doing this. I love that she considered me in it. Why would I not buy into this product or service?
On top of the listening time, that's something that got me, because getting somebody's attention talking about an IRA for in a few seconds on social media is like impossible. It's one of the most boring topics ever. Right. I mean, I love it, but it's a pretty boring topic. I get it. So yeah,
you know, if you did a podcast episode titled "Guess Who Won't Go Broke During the Pandemic," I'm listening.
Just go like all into detail about retirement, investing. Oh, everything that this show basically is, bringing on the education.
Right.